next speaker, we are about 15 minutes behind. We got started about 15 minutes late. Just registration took longer, parking took longer. I get it. So we're a little bit behind. We're going to run a little bit into lunch, but we'll catch up this afternoon. So anybody who's like my daughter, who's all about timekeeping, who is stressed out about the agenda, be reassured. We will get back on track. Okay. Our next speaker is probably one of the most high-energy people that I know. So perfect to follow up Rebecca. Absolutely. When she sets her mind to something, there is no stopping her. We all need people like that in our lives as well. I remember when I first met her at a business luncheon, she was the keynote speaker, and she told me about her dreams to transition from being a private practice psychologist to becoming a high-performance business coach, speaker, and trainer. And she was already a best-selling author. She has definitely accomplished what she has set out for herself as her goal and is now the founder of Massive Business Success Coaching. Okay, I thought maybe I missed my cue on the slides there. Massive Business Success Coaching while also maintaining her small private practice. Like Erin earlier today, she was also recently named as one of the top 20 most powerful women in Northern Nevada, and she brings expertise in human behavior and change to help others go from where they are to where they want to be, and to create a business and a life that they are obsessed with. I love that. She's married to her husband, Garth. She has three lovely children, Grace, Emily, and Zachary. And I'd love to welcome Dr. Erin up to the stage.
Oh my goodness. Oh, thank you. Hi, everybody. Oh my gosh. If any of you have been a speaker or want to be a speaker, I'm taking her on the road. She's mine, so you're going to have to work with my schedule, because she's going to make me look really good. Like, she's going to make me look like you're all happy. The first thing my now husband said to his family before they met me was, I just have to warn you, she has a really loud laugh. Like a laugh that startles small babies and is highly annoying if you don't know my heart. Okay? So thank you. That was amazing. Okay, I just got to run through. Mandy, today has been amazing. Give a round of applause to Mandy. I led an event here 2 weeks ago because Justin Timberlake's in the lobby, and if he's here and Beyonce, like, you should do an event at the coolest place in Reno. And I know what it takes to lead an event, and she's made this look so easy, okay? So I'm going to be talking about how to become a high performer, and you just got me off of 4 days with Brendon Burchard. Who knows me some Brendon Burchard? Oh, no. Okay, he's Oprah's coach. You should get to know him. He's the top high-performance coach in the world. He's my coach. He has a 4-day event called High Performance Academy, and we dance, and we live our dreams for 4 days, and you're getting me after him. Okay, so sorry. And my dream was to meet him, and I met him, and he even said my name this time, so I'm really happy. Okay, so he said my name. He's like, say hello to Dr. Erin. I was like, oh my God, that sounds so good. Okay, so I just have to thank you. Mandy, you will see in my talk that one of my sales strategies is to go on coffee dates, and literally what that means is I love people. And Mandy was one of my 213 coffee dates in 1 year. I didn't set out to do 213 coffee dates. I set out to love people and make an impact, and she was one of them. And my friend, you're amazing. Erin, top 20, high performer, top powerful women in Nevada. It was a voting thing, so I was texting. My massage therapist said, I've never seen a texting arm like yours. I'm like, I'm texting for votes. I was like, please vote for me. You could vote every day. I was like, it's like American Idol. Like, do you want to vote again? How about now? How about today? You can vote again. And I won through votes. So I don't know what Erin won through, but I won through votes and texting people like, how about today? Vote for me today. Erica, ask for what you want. It's my number one sales strategy. I got on this stage by saying, Mandy, I would love to add value to your people. I would love to share with you what I share. If you think it's a great fit, do it. Ask yourself to the party, people. Ask yourself to the party. Okay? Laura, balance. Okay? I just hired my Domino's pizza man because I do not cook. He got to know me on a first name level because I do not cook so much that we got to know each other. He's a marketing genius. He's working Domino's because his wife has a heart condition and he needs to work three jobs. And he knows everyone that you all know in this community. And he's going to take me to my next level of success. So thank you. I believe you can get your way to the top without cooking. Okay, so Danielle, I asked for a coach briefcase. Oh yeah, when I graduated, I'm like, can I have a coach briefcase? I didn't even think about like something to further my development. So kudos to you. Okay, I was like, you know, I don't even have that briefcase right now, right? And you know what? Assertive communication style. My 16-year-old daughter just broke up with her boyfriend, and I just got the text when we were sitting here to the mom saying, I'm sorry you don't know the full story. I want the best for him. And we're not happy now. Like, she's assertive, okay? My 13-year-old daughter 2 weeks ago got up on this stage, this same room. She said, I want to share my story of bullying. I'm scared to death, Mom. I said, okay. She goes, what if I cry? I said, that'll be perfect. And she got up, and I sat, and I was like, go, Emily. And she bawled, and I said, you got this. They need to hear this story. And she had a standing ovation at the end of it, and people want her to be the ambassador for bullying in their schools. Like, be courageous, you guys, okay? Rebecca, okay, you queued me up because we're going to be talking about playing hard. We just played hard. And I want to talk to you about high performance. So I have a business, and we help people get amped in their life and their business. And the amped life is the charged life. And the amped life, I got this in the shower one morning. Listen to this. We're activated. It's an acronym. I didn't even know it. We're motivated. We're productive. We're energized. And we're disciplined. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I was like, thank you, Jesus. That was amazing. Okay? So let's talk about what a high performer is. So Brendan Burchard, my mentor, he's the king of high performance. I'm a psychologist. He's been studying us for 30 years and created high performance, the science of it, and really became the person that brought it to a professional level so that we can teach people how to become high-performing teams. And here's what we found. His book, High Performance Habits, go get it. Read it. It's my Bible. It's the best. It's 3 years of research science of all the high performers in the world, all that he could find. And that's high performers like Olympians, but it's like the best basket weaver in the world. Like, how do you do it, right? A high performer, I want to give you the definition so we know what we're talking about. A high performer has success above standard norms. That's point one. They're outperforming their peers. How do they do it? Second point of high performers, they have success over the long term. So we have this pseudoscience called peak performance, and anyone can launch a thing. I call it the sprint puke method. So you can sprint and launch a thing, and then you burn out. High performance isn't about the sprint puke technology. High performers have decades of success above the average norms for decades. And the last thing is, this is what I love the most as a psychologist, they have a sense of well-being. Oh God, they're healthy. They're healthy. And they have awesome relationships. So high performers, guess what words they don't use? Hustle. Kinda. Grind. They don't use those words. They use joy. Passion. What else? What do you imagine? You're high performers here. Inspired. Motivated. Play. Okay? My best definition of success is from Maya Angelou. Success is liking yourself, liking what you do, and liking how you do it. And I know Amanda's going to be talking about this later. How you do a thing. Okay? So just pause and take a little personal assessment. How high performing are you in your life right now? Oh, let me go back. Sorry. The six arenas of a high performance life. And here's the myth. We can have balance, my friends. Oprah said you can't have it all, but you can't have it in the same week. And that's true. But if you think of these six pillars as cogs on a wheel, what happens if one of the cogs is totally lame? Right? There is like a kink in your wheel, and you are like lugging along, right? So my friends, you can have balance. Here's the definition of balance. It is not time spent, equally in all areas. It is level of satisfaction and happiness equally in all areas. I am so happy not to be cooking. I am so happy to have the Domino's pizza guy coming. My husband is happy with that because we have a plan for our life. We have a plan for the next year, and it does not involve me cooking. It doesn't. Thank you, God, for my husband, right? It doesn't involve that right now. But look at those areas. Love is your intimate relationship. Family and friends, self-explanatory. Your health. Are you vibrant? Do you have the energy you need? Do you get through every day with the energy you need? Do you have a 1 to 2 o'clock slump? Research has shown there's nothing biological about that, you guys. That's conditioning. There doesn't need to be a 1 to 2 hour slump. Okay? Power plants don't have energy, they generate energy. Repeat after me. Power plants don't have energy. They generate energy. Thank you. I did that totally wrong, didn't I? Power plants don't have energy. They
generate.
High performers take what's coming at them and they turn energy into a new thing and they transmit it. That's what a power plant does. People are like, how'd you get so much energy? I used to be clinically depressed, you guys, suicidal 8 years ago. I was not this person. I generated my own joy, and you can too. You can too. Your mission is your job. It's your career. It's usually what you get paid for. That's your work. Your play and hobbies. How hard are you playing? So if you think about Olympians, the level at which they perform, they need to rest and recover. The level that we perform, we need to play and have fun. When I play, I play hard. I want you to play hard and enjoy it. And spirituality, what's your meaning here on the planet, right? Okay, so the five pillars, we're going to go through them really quickly. A is activated. High performers are no different than you. They just activate themselves differently than you and more often than you. They're constantly asking themselves, who do I want to show up in the world and be? Am I being that in this meeting? Who do I want to go into this meeting? Brené Burchard told me the number one question Oprah asked for 25 years at Harpo Studios for every single meeting she ever had was, who wants to know the question? She asked 25 years at Harpo Studios. Every meeting she would start and she would say, what is your intention for this meeting? Every single one. Motivated. People struggle more than anything. This is what I hear as a coach. I'm just not motivated. Like, I just can't get myself out of bed. And, oh, my God, I'm so bored and blah, blah, blah. We're going to talk about that. Productivity. We don't want to be busy. Busy is like a badge we want to, like, rip off, right? We want to be energized and disciplined. So let's rock through this. So activated is, everyone's going to have a question I want you to ask yourself. Activated question is, who am I being? I want you to think to your core, who is your ideal self? If you could only choose 3 words to describe your ideal self, what would they be? I want you to go home and journal all the words that would describe yourself and imagine you could only choose 3 on your tombstone. What would those 3 words be? She was, he was. I'm literally thinking of getting a tattoo on my wrist of my 3 words, which is so weird for me, but I think I'm going to do it. So it's changing my life. I want you to think of your 3 words. This was one of my clients from my last event here at Whitney Peak, and she sent me this. Find your 3 words. Here's the coolest trick. Put them on your alarm in your phone, and every 3 hours they go off, and it's silent, and they're like, it cues your brain. So remember, high performers aren't different than you. They just activate themselves differently than you, and more often. So Brené Burchard, 15 times a day, he activates his 3 words. He's the number one paid, highest performance coach, Oprah's coach, Clinton's coach, Usher's coach, all the coaches, right? He looks at his 3 words 15 times a day. Okay, so motivation. So this is my friend Debbie, and I'll tell you a quick little story. The question for your motivation is, am I serving greatly? How can I serve and lead greatly today? That's your motivation, my friends. And when you wake up and you're like, I just don't want to get through my day, you got to ask yourself, how can I serve greatly? And you will get right out of that. So I had a mission 2 years ago. I wanted to become a speaker and do this thing and help thousands of people. And it was scary as heck. And I didn't know what the heck I was doing. I was in private practice for 16 years. Okay, I didn't know how y'all did this networking thing. I'd never been to one of these. Mandy? It was like the second one I had been to when I met you, okay? And I went to the Minden Pool with my kids, and I met this woman, Debbie. And we're talking, because I can talk to anybody. And I told her my dream for some reason. I'm like, I want to be a speaker. And she's like, well, I'm a marketing guru. I'm like, awesome. Like, I need your help, right? I said, I want to be a professional speaker, Debbie. How does one do that? And she said, I think you speak. Like, that is brilliant. How do I do that? And she helped me do it, and I spoke 43 times last year, okay? I didn't know how to do it. I hired a speaking coach. I hired an event coach. I hired a sales coach. I didn't know how to do any of this. But I did it because I was motivated by reaching people and helping people. Just last month, these 14 women here in Reno, we shut down the street of Reno. It was so cool. We had this video producer, and we made a movie about our book. It's called Reno Rising, and it's a movement across the United States. It's 14 stories of just struggle to triumph. And Hillary Sheevy, our female mayor, wrote the foreword in it. And we're on mission, ladies, to rise up women in leadership. Okay? So I had a vision in my mind. That's our book. We went Amazon bestseller in 2 hours. Okay? So this weekend, I was, just last summer, I mean, I was at Tahoe with Zachary, he's 7. I have 3 kids, he's one of them. And he looked through Bryn's telescope and he saw this boat across the way and he's like, I see humans! And I'm like, that is my marketing strategy. I saw humans, you guys. I went on 213 coffee dates. I do love coffee. I do love coffee. Okay? And Mandy was one of them, like I said. But my mission was to connect with people. And the greatest leadership coach of all times, John Maxwell says, no, Jim Rohn said, that's a different point. Jim Rohn said, when you help enough people get what they want, you will get what you want. You can't know what people want unless you're understanding what they want. And people don't give a crap about how much I know until they know how much I care. I'm a PhD, which means piled higher and deeper, my friends. Just kidding. Okay. So P is productive. Now, who when they were little was like, what do you want to be when you grow up? And you're like, I want to be busy. No, you didn't. Okay? No one wants to be busy. Okay? We want to get to the end of our day and our head hits our pillow and we're like, I accomplished everything I wanted to accomplish. I am rocking my life. Like, bring on the day, right? Okay? So you're not being productive just to add more to your plate. So let's talk about how do high performers get more done? Because they get way more done. And they don't burn out and they're not fatigued. So if you think of Oprah, she's the classic high performer. She's gotten more done than most humans on the planet. She's not like, oh my God, I'm just so exhausted. She's not. She's like full of energy. She's full of it, right? So how do they get that? Power plants don't have energy. They generate energy. Awesome, you guys. They have focus. They have goals. So I talked about Debbie. I had a dream. So last year, I was like, I will work with Brendan Burchard. I will. And I got to his first event. I was like, I'm getting closer. I'm like, I had the cutout. I'm like, I don't know how I'm going to work with Brendan Burchard. I'm like, okay, we're getting close. I hear you. He's like, hi, Erin. Hi, Dr. Erin. What do you, you know? Then I'm like, okay, getting closer. They brought the cardboard cutout. I'm like, too soon? We got this? I'm like, oh my God, there's a high five. Bring him home. Bring him home. I was like, you guys, I don't think I'm going to meet him. Like, he doesn't let anyone talk to him. He doesn't let it. Like, he can't. He speaks for 5 days. Like, he can't. They're like, bring him home to Inspire Reno and put him by the fireplace and everyone can come and meet and greet him. I'm like, yeah, I'll bring him home. And I did it. And he's my coach. When you have a vision in your mind, and I want you to think about, how do you want to lead your team? What's your goal? What's your vision? The brain will find what it goes looking for. If you've ever been pregnant, all of a sudden all the pregnant people come out in the world, you're like, where do they come from? Like, all of a sudden everyone's pregnant, right? I was looking for a white Mercedes, all of a sudden they were everywhere. Like, where did all the white Mercedes come from? Every networking group I go to, I ask myself, I wonder who are the two people I will meet, the most successful, passionate, energetic, wonderful, kind people. And I wonder how we're going to play together, and I wonder how we're going to add value to each other, and I wonder how we're going to grow together, and I wonder. And guess what? I find them every time. So start wondering. Your brain doesn't know when it's telling a lie. Psychology tells us that. Tell it something that's interesting to you. When I had my dream 2 years ago, I visualized 3 things. I visualized people doing this at my events, and I made them, so they did it. I visualized the look on my husband's face. And here's the reason. It was the why behind the goal. That look that someone captured for me, is called peace. He said, did you know this was going to go that well? And I'm like, oh, hell no. Like, I just got the coolest spade. I didn't know if anyone would come. I just wanted to be the girl that went for it. Can I get an amen? Like, I just wanted to be the girl who went for it. And they came and they paid, and it was amazing. But we woke up the next day, and the look on his face, that's why I was getting out of bed, you guys. Okay? And the last thing I had was I wanted people to text me and other people and be like, I was at Dr. Erin's event, and it was life-changing. And I just pictured these texts coming. And Trudy brought her husband. There was a sea of women and a few good men. Okay? There was two men in the audience. And I'm like, how did Larry do? Like, how's Larry feeling? Right? And she goes, oh, my God. She texted me. She goes, Larry loved it. He's a talented artist. And I told people, use your gifts. Like, it's your gift. Right? He's always been afraid to put himself out there. He told me on the way home he wants to use his gifts. And then a week later, I got this text, you guys. He sold his first painting. Give it up for Larry. Like, come on. Like, I am now coaching with Brendan. If you are my friend, you would say the same thing to me. You would say, of course you are. You've been talking about him for 2 years. Like, it is so in my brain. I have dreams about Brendan, and I love Garth, but I have dreams. He's like, Brendan, Brendan, Brendan. My husband's like, Brendan, 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 you know? I guess I woke up one night, and I was like, chapter 3, and I grabbed his hand. I guess we're writing a book together, right? Okay? So when we're talking about productivity, I want you to imagine, what would it look like if you SWAT teamed your hours? If you study the high performers, they work in 52 to 55 minute increments. After 52 to 55 minutes, they get up and they move for 2 to 5 minutes, or they get up and do a water. They do not check their, you know, scroll. No, they are activating their body. They're doing laughter. They are doing so much physiology that I teach people. They are changing their physiology. I just want you to imagine, what would it look like if you SWAT teamed your dream? Like, I'm going in. Okay? I want you to imagine having an instinct to ship. Seth Godin was on Marie Forleo. I get to meet her next weekend. Amazing! So Seth Godin says, we need an instinct to ship, not an instinct to perfect. So become a person that's addicted with shipping. And what I mean by that is putting it out there. Become a person of action. Don't wait to perfect it. If I know an email's due on my email list, I sit down and write it. I don't hem and haw and ask for feedback and blah, blah, blah. I just ship it. Become so addicted to shipping and not perfecting. Okay, because the process is going to perfect you. You know, take the buzzer management of Jeopardy. If you look at the people that win Jeopardy, they're not the smartest one in the room. They're what? They hit the buzzer right before the other person, right? And when do they hit the buzzer, you guys? Before the question is even full. And they're like, just a second, let me film. Just a second. You guys, this strategy is what high performers do. They don't have to have it all figured out to export, to ship, to be content, to share content, to say, I got this idea. I don't know how. I don't know how it's going to all work. Let's go with it. And here's the thing about high performers. I call them the queens of no and the kings of no. I'm the queen of no. I've gotten so good at saying no. Are you good at saying no? Figure out what is on your not-to-do list. Let's just shout it out. If your dream is waiting on you, what needs to be on your not-to-do list? Go. Cooking. Oh, my God, I love you. Cooking. Cleaning. No, freaking amen. Like, cleaning needs to go. That was the first thing to go for me. Then it was cooking. What else? What? Apologizing. What else? Emails all day long. Cat videos? Anybody? Anybody? Cat videos. What else? Feeling guilty. Amen. Excuses. One more. Beer. Beer. Oh, fear. Fine. Oh, my God! No, I did not. It's not required. Thank God the research does not say that, right? Or coffee. We can still have coffee. Oh, my God, that's hysterical. Fear. That's so funny. Fear. Fear. So what was on my list was like the PTA, not these 2 years, some other years. No PTA, no TV. There's a lot of stuff that's not on my to-do list. There's a lot of coffee dates that are not on my to-do list. And it's been tough. I want you to find your why. That was my why. That's my family, all blondes. Here's how you get to your deep why. And you've heard Simon Sinek maybe on TED Talk, but and we hear about your why. But here's how I want you to help you psychologically get to your why. Your why is usually about 5 to 7 layers deep, and you can ask yourself, share your goal with yourself. So I want this. I want 200,000. I want 500,000. I want, you know, 10 new employees. I want whatever you want. And then ask, so that, and go down 5 to 7 layers deep. So when you're the daughter of a high-performance coach, psychologist coach, you get texts like this when it's New Year's Eve, 2017. My mission for 2017 is, and she responds, you know, I want to do a cheer. I want to do like back handsprings. When you're the 13-year-old daughter of a high-performance coach, psychologist coach, then you get another text that says, so that? And look at what my sweet pea Emily wrote. So I can show the real me. The real me is confident, happy, strong, and never willing to give up. People, it's not about the handspring. It's not about the promotion. It's about how you're going to feel, or how you're going to help other people feel, or the look on your husband's face when you put your toes in the sand at Cabo. That's what you're going for. You better believe that you've got to have that dream in front of you every single day. On my phone, come and ask me. I made a collage of my dreams. You've got to tell your dream what you're working on. Productivity is not about time management, you guys. It's about dream management. Do I need more energy? Oh, my God. Okay, so let's talk about energy. So here's the thing we know about energy. It's a performance enhancer. So if you study all high performers of the world, and again, they're statistically above the average Joe, right? And they're getting more done in the same amount of time, because I'm going to tell you how much they sleep, and you're going to be really mad at me. But they sleep a lot, so you can't use that excuse. So how the heck do they get so much done? It's because power plants don't have energy. They generate energy. Here's your ladder of vibrancy. I want to challenge you. High performers, the research says, they take 1 to 2 breaks an hour. We talked about 52 to 55 minutes. They eat 2 to 4 meals a day. Now, if you're a high-performing like athlete, like do your own thing. But how many Americans need more opportunities to graze on bad shit? Like, we don't need it, right? Like, we don't need it. We don't need it, right? Eat 2 to 4 meals a day, okay? Right? Our plates are really big in America. 4 to 5 liters of water a day. Here's the thing. That's about a gallon and a half. You're not going to flow away. You're not going to have, like, kidney dysfunction from drinking too much water. When your cells are dehydrated, they actually don't touch. When your cells don't touch, you're not creative, you're not productive, you're not energized, you're not in your zone, okay? So cells need to be hydrated, and then they touch. So start your morning with 3 cups of water right when you get out of bed. High performers work out 5 to 6 times a week. But here's the good thing. It's only 20 minutes, and it can be whatever you want it to be, okay? High performers earn more because they exercise more. So I literally tell myself on the treadmill, look at me growing my empire. Look at me growing my empire. I literally do. Tell yourself whatever you need to do. I literally do. I also tell myself, like, look at me being a good mom. Because we all know what happens if Erin doesn't exercise. So, okay, 5 to 6. Oh, I said that, workouts. 6 to 7 meditations a week. Okay, I'm like meditation resistant. I don't know. I'm so resistant. But I'm learning. Start out with 2 minutes. Rewires your brain. Start out with just telling yourself, release, 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 release. Do whatever you need. Just set a timer on your phone. It dings. You're like, done. I'm a high performer. And then sleep 7 to 9 hours a night. Okay, if you are not there, just try to get yourself 1 more hour. Okay? And if you tell me, like, I can get by on 4 to 5 hours, Erin. No, we're not about getting by. We're about thriving, not getting by. You look at presidents. After 4 years, watch their hair color change, right? That's what 4 hours of sleep gets you. So Arianna Huffington, if you study all the 50 years of, you just can't bend me on this one. Like, you can say, but you're not going to bend me, because Arianna Huffington, all the 50 years of research says Our brain at night's like a dishwasher. It like takes out the toxins. It's called the dishwasher effect. Isn't that fascinating? Last one is discipline. So, you know, in the UK have that sign, mind the gap. So the gap that I call the knowing-doing gap is that gap of, I know what to do. Why don't I do what I know? Most of you know, I should be drinking water. Of course I know this. Why don't we do it? Okay? You've got to set your dream in front of you and know the science that my dream depends on it. Okay, when you've competed in a bodybuilding competition, you just have to find a way to put in your slides. You just have to find a way. And you put in your wallet, if anyone wants to see it. And you put it on your fridge in case anyone comes over. I didn't have dreams of being a bodybuilder on stage. I had dreams of not eating Oreos. I wanted to be a woman of integrity. I wanted to not do what I didn't want to do. And I wanted to do what I wanted to do. That's what that was about for me. Go and be congruent with your ideal self. Who would your three-word self tell you to be? Who would she or he say, show up in this meeting as her? Have a meeting with her before you go in and say, who are we being? Okay, here we go. Okay? Do it. Do not let your learning lead to knowledge. Let it lead to action. Okay, there's the psychology that the best way to change anything in your life is to behave your way there, not to think your way there, and wait around for the thinking. So I'm going to sing you a song. If you're happy and you know it, overthink. If you're happy and you know it, overthink. If you're happy and you know it, give your brain a chance to blow it. If you're happy and you know it, overthink. Okay? No, we're going to behave our way into different thinking. Write that down. You're not going to think your way into a different behaving. I didn't think I was competent to be on that bodybuilding stage until after I won the trophy. And I was like, huh. I didn't have any confidence. Confidence is overrated, my friends. Like, go in and know you can figure it out. And watch what happens when you do the thing and it grows your confidence. Okay? The last thing I'm going to say, psychology of high performers, love this slide because I'm a psychologist. You need to believe in yourself. Okay, a couple things I just want to share with you about high performers. They're very courageous. It's like the foundational bedrock. So this is Emily speaking 2 weeks ago, and Emily was the one that got bullied. And she was shaking. She's like, Mom, I think I want to speak. I'm like, okay, what do you want to talk about? She's like, confidence. Okay. She's like, I'm so scared. I'm like, I know. Been there. She goes, I think I want to do it. What if I cry? I'm like, that'll be perfect. And she got the standing ovation, right? People are asking her, can you be the bully ambassador for our school? She's like, I think I changed people's lives, Mom. I'm like, that's what happens when you step out of your comfort zone, people. Okay? Break it up. Break up with your comfort zone. It's not you, it's me. Finally realizing you're terrible for me. Okay? So write a letter to your comfort zone. And no one uses this. I got to trademark this, okay? Dear comfort zone, it was love at first sight. We made a good pair. At first I thought you were good for me because, and fill in your line, but it's just not working out. I've changed and you haven't. It's time for us to go our separate ways. We have to break up because. Love the new me. And Mandy will send you the slide so you can write your little letter. And then last, fail fast, my friends. Thomas Edison said, I didn't fail 10,000 times. I found 10,000 ways it didn't work. I call it, wrap up. Climb what I call the bad, good, great ladder. 2 years ago, I knew when I first tried to do this, I was not going to be great. I was going to be kind of bad. I didn't know how to speak. I didn't know how to sell from the stage. I fell in love with being bad so I could learn how to be good. And then I knew if I did what was good long enough, I'd hopefully turn out to be great. And I knew someday I'm going to be expected to be the expert. So why not fall in love with being great and just messing it all up and be like, that was my first time. That was so bad. It was, you guys. I have friends that witnessed it, okay? Yes, we were at Brendan's, and my friend Lee was in rooming with us. She's like, I'm just so glad I witnessed the 2017 Dr. Erin. I'm like, oh, my God. Like, was it that bad? Okay? Just fall in love with being that. Because everyone has to climb it. Brendan Burchard started with 13 people at the Ramada Inn, and he had a boombox, and he played the music, and he was like, come on, everybody. And then he's like, just a second, and he turned it off. Okay, Brendan Burchard, billionaire, okay? Okay. Just climb the bad, good, great ladder. Who Who's ready to be a high performer? Thank you so much. I came between you and lunch. Thank you, Mandy.